Oh, that's rough. That makes me sad. I'm not going to say it's surprising, but all right, we can't go that way. Oh, so this is as far back as we can backtrack then. All right, well, thanks for wasting my time, game. I really appreciate everything you do, and I hope that all the people that have helped you die in a fire. And Mike Matai, that guy, I put about as much stock into his opinion as I put into the opinion of, like, my socks when I put them on in the morning. It's a man who thinks he has way more clout than he does. And I'll never understand why people take him so seriously, but they do. It begins! Yes, let your hate consume you! Okay. That was an attempt at something. Oh, we can go down here now. The ground is no longer, like, mega irradiated. Yeah, I know that's where he got his start with the angry video game nerd. I don't know. Dude got a platform, and now everybody thinks he's worth listening to, which, that tends to be the way of things. I'm not gonna worry about it. It's very much one of those, like, he can spout whatever crap he wants, I'm just not going to listen, because I'd rather listen to somebody whose opinion I actually value. Okay. Oh, where you at? Oh, that was a bad idea. Oh, wow. All right, chain gun apparently, ah, shit. No, I'm dead. I'm somehow not dead. It would be great if enemies flinched when you shot them with weapons in this, but they don't. Yeah, I don't know. That's one of those things where it's like the spoony one, where I'm sure in some aspect he's just doing it because it rustles jimmies. The problem is that, like, when people do that and they have a fan base, they rustle. They do it to troll, but people take it seriously. And that's where it causes problems. Like, the spoony one's whole spiel about how, like, Ultima Underworld 2 is a bad game because he got eaten alive by a headless that you're not supposed to fight in the beginning, and everyone's like, oh, it's so bad! It's like, no! He's playing it up for yucks, guys. Come on now, it's not my fault you're too stupid to realize that. Exactly! Let people have fun. Just do what you want to do. Yeah, Arcurus, he went on this whole tirade about how if you emulate games and you use save states to win them, that you're not actually beating the game. Which, alright, sure, okay. Maybe you gotta tell yourself, bro. I will never understand why that matters, but apparently to him it really does. Exactly, like, that's my general thoughts on him as well, is he just does not interest me, and he does not engage me in any way in anything that I've seen him with, so... Pass. Ooh. Ooh. Oh. No. There's the plasma gun. Ooh. He did. Somehow managed to get a second salvo off before he died, though. I was gonna say, I hear spiders. Just two? Alright. Take that ammo. And we will continue onward. See what kind of bullshit's gonna spawn while I'm navigating this. Nice. Good troll. I don't think I killed that imp, did I? Oop. Take a moment, reload our shotgun, collect ourselves here. Take a PDA, quick save. Alright. Oop. Eh. ridiculous. Imp? Oh no, we did get the barrel, nice. Oh, it looks like we're going outside. Rocket launcher! Now we get to play the how many times is Gene gonna explode himself game. Cause I can guarantee y'all it's gonna be more than one! I'm not careful, it's gonna be right here. Oh, I'm waiting. I'm waiting. Wow. Dem explosion physics, though. Oh, I'm terrible. I am just fucking bad. Man, Rocket's just zooming everywhere. Look at it. He's chasing me, but he just can't quite get me. I turn too hard for him. A for effort, though, buddy. I like how the rocket just eventually phased out of existence in this. Even in Doom 2. Even in Doom 2, they would chase you, I think, until they blew up. Not in Doom 3, though. We have standards here. Oh, god damn it. More than 10? Absolutely more than 10. Here goes our oxygen. Oh, precious suffocation damage. The fuck was that? Bay door, please. Oh, it was you. Get out of here. We escape into an area transition. You guys, I think something may be wrong here. The geckos do look pretty freaking bad. I don't know how they got to that from like what the original geckos demons look like. Like at least make them look like scaly or something. Oh hey!
Making progress, are we? And in such a hurry to find this, to find me. There's no need to rush. I am everywhere, and everything here is mine. It's a pity you did not alert the fleet, but it is of no consequence. I'll alert them myself. They will come to the rescue and be consumed by my legion. We will use their ships to bring this hell to Earth. You won't live to see it. And you will die long before you have a chance to warn them.
Bored now. Nope. Nope. Anybody else? I hear. Ah, there he is. Nope. Nope. Okay. So, yeah, that was Betruger. I love it. The game gives you, like, one choice. Do you want to send a distress call or not? And then this happens. He's like, it doesn't matter that you didn't send it. I'm going to send it. The pump is active. Okay. And I guess we can top off our health. When do I kung fu fight the rock? I don't know. Wasn't the pinky in the Doom, like, completely tangential? The pinky in the Doom movie, wasn't it like some dude in a wheelchair or something? Because that's how you get from A to B. Oh, is this the part of the game where Betruger monologues while I lay waste to everything that stands before me? It was? Okay. There are a few things I remember from that dumpster fire, but that and, the first person sequence are, like, the only things. Both disappointing, I will say. They sealed the door? Why would you do that? What the fuck you doing, buddy? I would just love for an imp to die in just one shot. It's apparently too much to ask to kill an imp with a single shotgun shell.
There's nothing left
for you. Chain gun. Jesus Christ, this fucking game. fossils. I want to waste all these things and then go back for that health charge station.
Due to the threat of external enemies, hazard doors sealed.
You may blow now, thank you. Okay. The first person scene in the Doom movie, it was unique. Like, it wasn't bad, I suppose. But that's probably about the most positive thing that I can say about it. That movie was just like ill-fated. Just from the start, that movie was just ill-fated. It was kind of like the Dungeons and Dragons movie. Like, there's just no way it's not going to be a steaming pile. It's not how any of this works. Okay, ammunition locker number 3. This is 483. Sure, I'll take it. Why not? Welcome back, Cell. So, but I've seen the first Doom movie, and that is where I stopped. I don't think I've recovered from the, I remember during my Let's Play, I think I made a Shao Kahn reference there. Your soul is mine. He's gotta kill us first. Don't think I didn't see that sitting there. Uh-oh. To be fair, I didn't even know that they made Doom movies past the first one, so it's not intentional avoidance. Now, my avoidance of the Dungeons and Dragons movies, that's intentional. Although I did watch the second one, I think, Wrath of the Dragon God, just to make sure, and they're bad. The first one at least had Jeremy Irons. Wrath of the Dragon God was just a bunch of randos. And, well, I guess Damodar was in it, but he doesn't count. It came out last year, okay. Exactly, Arcurus. Like, if you want to sell me, like, Doom media like that, do, like, a 20-second, like, little clip or something. You know, maybe, like, a 10-minute Flash video. Although, Flash is... Wow, that fucking zig around that rocket there, I'm pleased with myself on that. That was actually intentional for once. Look at me dodging projectiles. Yeah, you're not wrong, Dar, but that doesn't make them not bad. I'm not going, like, they're bad movies. I'm not going to judge them for having made them, but I'm not going to say, well, I'm not going to defend them based on not having a budget. They should have just not made the things. Oh, are we going to fight, like, the babies? I remember there being babies and taking a strange amount of glee in taking the chainsaw to them. Dragons? That was the Dragonlance movie, wasn't it? I never actually saw it. I just heard tales about how bad it was. How does this... Chainsaw's pretty good on imps. Good to know. The first one... The first one had Jeremy Irons in it, and it had fucking one of the Wayans brothers, I can't remember which one. And the first one was great just for Jeremy Irons. That man, like, he knew what he was getting into, and he chewed that set. Oh, it was fucking perfection. I love it. Like, it is probably one of my favorite bad movies. But no, I have not seen the Dragonlance movie. Let's see, is there anything? Ooh, 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 ooh! Chainsaw's at the ready. I don't know what's out there, but I know it's coming for me. Alright. Got some ammo back here. Ooh! Chainsaw's imp from the back. Yeah, you're not wrong. He was no joke, like, tearing that scenery apart. That was so good. See, I don't know. Like, the second movie, it was just, like, a couple thieves. There was an elf and a dwarf and whatnot. The second one actually hit the party a little bit better for me. Because you had, like, a cleric in there. I think he was, like, a cleric of Obadiah or whatever. And that dragon iced him at the very end. Well, not even at the end, like, midway point. I just remember him trying to flame strike his way through a white dragon deity thing's breath, and it ended poorly. Seriously, game? Alright, that's a lot of imps. There's only one solution to imps. Death. Probably gonna bring out the plasma rifle for this. I love that they give me the rocket launcher and then they immediately throw me into all of these tight corridors where I am not going to do anything with it except ruin my own day. Imp? I say. Not one of you suckers spawned in behind me. I don't know, like, Wrath of the Dragon God, for what it was, it seemed like a better, I guess, like a better representation of, like, D&D than the first movie was. But it was just, like, kind of fucked by everything else. Oh, that's sadness. Seriously, guy? Seriously, get out of here. Get out of here. Nobody likes you. You smell like cabbage. Let's see. I am going to quick save him. You're gonna backtrack. What's up, Billy? Welcome. Hope you're doing well today. I was trying to disarm a trap, and everyone look away because of trade secrets. Yeah. Like the first movie had some nice. What in the? That just looks bad. The first movie had some nice touches to it. Absolutely. But I came from this way. No, I totally did come from this way. I think I even left those things there. Not those, though. And there's a healing. This freaking game. Just give me the healing, and I'm going to be on my way. Yeah, we're raging. Well, not really raging, but yes, we're talking about the D&D movies. I should get, like, some clips of Jeremy Iron from the first D&D movie and use them on here. Like, frickin' Prophions let their blood rain from the sky, like where he's like just spitting everywhere and shaking his fists. Yeah, that was kind of my view on it as well, is that like the second one had, it was a much more standard, like it was something you could see being a tabletop game, whereas the first one was less that. Oh god. Don't you be linking naughty things in chat, Dar. Don't tell me that's that whole fucking movie. Oh, is it the Let Their Blood Rain from the... I gotta know. Is this Let Their Blood Rain from the Skies? It better be. I'll be disappointed if it's not.
Blood rain from the sky!
God, that movie is so fucking bad! Oh, that needs to be, that's gonna be a thing, absolutely. Seriously, I cannot walk, there it goes. It is, exactly, it's so bad it's good. Jeremy Irons, like, just devouring the set, it's wonderful. I love it. It will become a thing. I promise you. I could do it now, but this is a pro stream, and we're here doing pro things. And this gentleman is approaching me in a threatening manner. Sir, I am armed. Ow. Ow. Jesus. You're seeing it, Celt. I know it might be difficult to watch, but this is what peak performance looks like when it comes to Doom 3. The only thing that I'm not showing you guys is all the doping I'm doing off screen and the, like, crying in a dark room, shaking back and forth. Absolutely! Absolutely, Dar. What the fuck am I even stuck on? I'm stuck on something that- oh my god. Doom 3! You know who else was a princess? Xena was a princess. She got her legs broken. That was interesting. Come on now. This is like, this chick was like Queen Amidala style boring. It was just like impressive how bland she was as a character. You fucker, I'm doping myself up on the, oh, no more meds. What the fucking hell? Where? Okay, so this thing shot a rocket at me from over here. Oh no, you need to die so that I can bitch about this. It shot a rocket at me from over here. I was coming through this door and it came through the door to hit me. Negative 917. Sometimes you gotta try hard on the negative hit points. Alright, now I know there's a zombie, but there's an imp. Maybe? Maybe not. That's probably just this guy I was thinking of. I don't know. I knew there was an imp back here. Apparently not. Xena was bad. Xena and, like, Hercules were terrible, but oh my god, they were great. Get fucked. You dick. Oh my god. The fucking thing is just not dying. There it goes. Lord. The thing that really blew my mind was when I found out that Izaro in Path of Exile is voiced by the guy that played Aeolus in Hercules. It tore my mind asunder when I found that out. No, oh, it's the babies! Which means it's time to give them hugs with a chainsaw. Man, I bet they were being, like, they thought they were being so edgy when they made these things. They'd be like, people are gonna freak out about killing babies in video games. And then you got people like me who are like, this is the best thing ever. More games need to let me do this. I remember when video games let you do that shit. Fallout. Yeah, ripped. I don't even know. Seriously? Is the shotgun just this bad, or did these not explode? Because I don't know which it is. I hear monster noises, and I'm afraid. The barrel's not red. They're the yellow ones explode too. I didn't know if those exploded as well. There have been more than just red exploding barrels in this. God, you guys, it's like you've not read the strategy guide. The yellow ones even explode on a delay. They don't blow up right away. Oh, the one time I needed to one shot. Whoa, physics. Backtrack for healing. Yeah, okay. Grab the armor. And up we go. Can I go under? No. Alright, yes, up we go. Can I go over? No. We might be able to go over. We're gonna try. Not saying much. Oh my god, what the fuck, game? Come on now. Oh my god. This game's platforming physics are so bad. Why did they even bother? Why? Just don't let me jump if you're gonna, like, fucking lazy out on the environmental navigation video games. Come on now. Like, alright, there's like a wall here. Except when there's not. Okay. Nope. Invisible ceiling. I love video games. Yeah, I remember the Soul Cube being pretty good. Who needs ammo when you have a chainsaw anyways? There it is. Rip and tear. Is that a mancubus I hear? I think it is. I would bet money it is. It's still too quiet. I buffed the voice, like the audio on that, by twice as much. I increased the volume on that clip by 200%. It's probably because I'm talking, because the audio of anything that my system is doing ducks when I'm speaking. I mean, it might still be too quiet regardless, but that's probably part of it. Mancubus, it can take 5 rockets. Did he just wow, an enemy that actually flinches. What is this? What's up, Mr. Meaner? Welcome. It has been a while. Glad to have you around. I'm sorry that of all the streams you decide to pop in on, it's this, but welcome all the same. Oh, is it just chainsaw fodder? Ow! Little shit. That's a paddling. That is accurate. That is completely accurate. And I fall into both of those categories. Alright. One thing that really irks me about this game is that, like, you've got the stamina bar, right? And you hold down shift to sprint. And if you run out of stamina while you're sprinting, and you don't release shift, the stamina bar does not start recharging, and you don't get any speed boost from what it should be recharging and you would be using from continuing to hold down shift. Because this is Doom 3. Doom 64 was a solid game. It was weird, but it wasn't bad. And I think it is absolutely a better game than Doom 3. That's not saying much. Feels like this is where we're supposed to go. Like, where did that thing climb out of? Was it just in there chilling out, sleeping, having a good time, rolling around in the muck? I don't know. I'm probably missing some stairs or an elevator or something. Yeah, look at that! I've played video games.